Jade, they say, and did he underachieve? Is there any concern with him?
I wouldn't think so. And, you know, obviously Arkansas fans are going to kind of look at it in the light that best suits them, because they want to believe that the coach they hired is the best coach in college basketball, which is what he has been for quite some time. You know, he's 65 years old, and like you said, he hasn't had recent success necessarily, especially in the NCAA tournament. But what Arkansas fans, and what I might even counter with, is that now you have a renewed and reinvigorated Calipari with a new environment, a change of scenery. You have massive amounts of dollars being thrown at NIL for him to use to his discretion. And it seems like, as well, he will be reuniting with a certain few staff members who he had a lot of success with at Kentucky, one being Kenny Payne, who I think most people are aware did not have a great tenure at Louisville and was let go at the end of this year. But Calipari had not done anything in the NCAA tournament without Kenny Payne. But when he and Kenny Payne were together at Kentucky, they went to multiple Final Fours and won a national championship, signed multiple number one recruiting classes. And I think all of those factors combining, I think he has a really good shot at having a good tenure at Arkansas.
Jackson Collier on tonight. Couple more. I'll let him run. Busy day. Calipari gets introduced as Arkansas head coach. He's with Arkansas Rivals. The best coverage, the podcast is Hardwood Hogs. So I've been hearing about the NIL money at Arkansas. How big is it? It seems like something that maybe sold Calipari on this.
I think that's a lot of what did sell him on the job. And, you know, we don't know an exact number right now, but a lot of major national reporters and outlets are reporting that it's going to be between $5 and $7 million, maybe even more.
I'll look at that number and say, okay, maybe he can get some guys in here in this new world of it's just wild. You have to have that much money for players. So what's the atmosphere like today? I saw they rolled out the red carpet. What's it feel like in Fayetteville?
Oh, it feels electric. You know, I'm not there. I'm in Michigan right now, but everybody that's there that I've been talking to and I've been watching the videos, and I can feel the electricity all the way from up north. I can't remember the last time the Arkansas fan base was this excited, and that's saying something, because the Arkansas fan base was very excited when they hired Eric Musselman, and the Arkansas fan base was very excited when Eric Musselman took them to two Elite Eights and a Sweet 16. The program as a whole travels really well. And so those NCAA tournaments, the environments were electric. But now, obviously, everybody's in Fayetteville. They had a welcome party on a Wednesday afternoon to greet John Calipari as he landed at Drake Field in Fayetteville. And it's just tangible excitement. I think people were starting to line up outside Bud Walton Arena 30 minutes or an hour before the doors even open, because his press conference is open to the public tonight.
Okay, I look at it and say he always recruits the best of the best, or he's tried getting the five-star guys. So I'm going to get these guys. We're going to be developing NBA players here. Is there got to be a change, Jackson, of, well, we need some of those guys, but we got to get some really good transfers here?
Oh, absolutely. And I think that definitely has to be a change. But also, I don't think he has any choice but to do that at Arkansas. Because right now there are zero scholarship players on roster and zero incoming freshmen. So he has a completely blank slate to work with, and there's no way he's going to fill that with 13 freshmen. So he's going to have to utilize the transfer portal.
Jackson Collier on tonight. He covers the Razorbacks for Arkansas Rivals, college basketball analyst, the podcast Hardwood Hogs. Find him on Twitter at Jackson Collier on a big day for Arkansas basketball. Musselman out and Calipari in. Jackson, good to have you. Thanks for hopping on.
Yes, sir. Thanks so much for having me on. Willing to come back anytime. Really appreciate it.
I appreciate your time. Jackson Collier on the Nate Brown Show tonight. Arkansas Rivals covers the Razorbacks on the college basketball side. Find him on Twitter X at Jackson Collier. John Calipari, the new head coach for Arkansas. I did not see that one coming, right? I don't think very many people did. So it's Eric Musselman's been a guy that I've watched. And I think if you're from Rapid City, you look at it and say, his history with the Thrillers and the whole thing, long history here. So I've watched Musselman in his career. Man, he's been climbing the ladder, was at Nevada, and then got an opportunity here at Arkansas, and now goes to USC. and I did not see Arkansas getting in the mix on John Calipari. Can Calipari turn it around? Meaning, I used to be in that Final Four and national championship contender, and Kentucky was supposed to be that. They haven't been that since 2015. I mean, they haven't been that high of a level since 2015. It's a long time ago now. I mean, they're always in the mix as, oh, they're a great program, but they haven't been that deep. I mean, Arkansas Musselman did better than Kentucky the last few years. So can Calipari now take that and roll with it at Arkansas? The word is he's got a bunch of NIL money. Jackson Collier saying, hey, the number could be $5 to $7 million. Think about how these coaches have to look. Okay, I got about $6 million of NIL money to use here. How are we going to work this out? How are we going to work this? It's just amazing to me, this new world order. Coming right back with Brian Noe, Fox Sports Radio national host. A lot to hit with Brian on the way.
You're listening to The Nate Brown Show. Follow us and watch the show live on Twitter at Nate Brown Show.
The wait is over. Ensemble entry doors exclusively from Renewal by Anderson have arrived with an incredible offer. Secure, timeless style, elegant features, customized countless ways with the legendary quality of Renewal by Anderson. Right now, you get 20% off every Ensemble entry door. No money down, no interest, and no payments for 12 months. No payments for a year. Please scan the QR code on your screen or visit rbarapidcity.com now to book your free estimate. Ensemble entry doors, the wait is over.
We are number one, so you can always be their number one. Black Hills Surgical Hospital and Black Hills Orthopedic and Spine Center. The number one hospital in the nation for major orthopedic surgery.
Ever wish you had a take back? Highmark Credit Union is pleased to offer innovative loans with take back. Most banks and credit unions make you choose between paying ahead on a loan or saving for emergencies. We do things differently. At Highmark, you can have both. Access the cash you paid above your monthly minimum whenever you need it. Make the smart money move. Highmark Credit Union. HighmarkFCU.com.
Building a new home in the Black Hills? At Builders First Source, we turn dreams into reality. Experience our skilled drafting services and use our 3D visualization tools to preview your home before construction begins. Discover inspiration in our showroom, meet our cabinetry design experts, and explore our wide selection of top quality materials. Visit us in Rapid City, Spearfish, or Hot Springs, or start online at bldr.com. Builders First Source, your partners in success from foundation to the finish. Finishing touches.
I'm with Brian at Anytime Auto Sales. Getting your car in tip-top shape for the summer months has arrived.
Yes, it has. And we're here for all your summertime automotive needs. We'll make sure your AC system is fully charged and functioning at full capacity. Plus, we have the best brake deal around at just $329 per axle for most vehicles, including pads, rotors, labor, and a lifetime warranty as long as you own the rig.
That brake deal is flat out the best deal around.
You know, it really is. And we have great prices for oil changes as well. Get a mobile synthetic blend 5-quart oil change for most vehicles for only $34.99 plus tax.
You do a lot of things at some great prices to keep anyone's rig running right.
You know, we do. Rebates for brand name tire deals, plus detailing specials too. Whatever your repairs may be, we'll do them right and at a fair price.
Anytime Auto Sales Service and Detail, folks. The place to trust. Your complete AAA and ASE certified automotive repair specialist. See anytime, anytime.com. And of course, on the corner of Highway 79 and East Minnesota, Rapid City.
Anytime Auto Sales.
In the past, if you needed auto body repair, you had to get multiple estimates and then try to get your car into a shop for repair. Well, not anymore. In most cases, you can stop by one shop, get your estimate, and schedule your car for a repair. The question now becomes which shop you choose. If you like quality, choose J&J Truck and Auto Body. They have ASE, PPG, and Gold iCar certifications that allow them to offer you a nationwide warranty. And they'll work with your insurance company so you're pleased with the outcome. J&J Truck and Auto Body, 1513 East Philadelphia.
Hi, it's Colin Coward. Great to be in the Black Hills. Getting heard weekdays 10 to 1 on 106.7 FM and 11:50 AM Fox Sports.
Welcome back in on a Wednesday, the Nate Brown Show, back and ready. South Dakota Sports Talk Show. Glad you're here. Weekdays 4 to 6. Unplanned vacation for me the last 2 days. You know what an unplanned vacation is, right? Me, myself, and I in my room. That's it. It was something. I'm grinding. We're okay. We're okay, everybody. I'm going to live. I have almost passed out Monday night, but we're going to live, okay? We're back and ready with Brian Noe, Fox Sports Radio. Find him on Twitter X at The Noe Show. And he's back on the Nate Brown Show tonight. Brian, how are you?
I am fantastic this evening, Nate Brown. It's a thrill to talk to you and give a shout-out, as always, to the Black Hills, man. It is an evening uplifter, I would say.
Oh, I love that. I love that. Well, I'm uplifting. I do know that. My audience likes you. I got a text, Brian, that says, Brian knows a great guest. Brian knows a great guest. So we're going to make this thing happen regularly, even more than we do. Okay, I want to get into this scenario. The last couple of days, people have talked about it. I was out sick. I'm back and ready. So I got to hit on this. The men's national championship I thought was great. I'm watching it when I'm sick. I'm sitting here. I'm like, man, this is a great basketball game. And then UConn pulls away as they do. The women's national championship was great. And then South Carolina pulled away. They're just too big, too much depth. So those games were great. Women's ratings beat the men by about 4 million. Now people say, well, the women's games trended up. The men's game is flatlined. But my answer is, I believe the women's college basketball game is going to fall off significantly, and the men will still hang around, depending who's playing in the game, that 15, 16 million mark. What do you say about it next year?
Yeah, I see it very similarly, Nate, where, and it's tough sometimes to have these conversations because you immediately feel like a hater or sound like a hater. But it's true. It was the perfect storm for the women. And props to them, man. To get almost 19 million viewers for the championship game is outstanding. But you've got Caitlin Clark, who is arguably the biggest draw in women's basketball ever. I mean, how can you argue against that when she's drawing the numbers that she has? She's gone. She's going to the WNBA. So you had Caitlin Clark, this ratings juggernaut, going up against an undefeated South Carolina team. The ratings just built and built. It was from the Elite Eight when it was the rematch of the championship last year between Iowa and LSU, the Caitlin Clark, Angel Reese thing. Then they're taking on UConn and how storied that program is. And there's some late game controversy with the illegal screen that's called, and then it just builds right into the championship game matchup. I think their numbers are definitely going to take a significant hit next season because they don't have that same ratings juggernaut girl like Caitlin Clark. I mean, you could have Juju Watkins or Paige Beckers, or you still could have some star power and some big numbers. I don't see the same numbers. And something else that you have to consider is, you've got the women's championship game was on ABC. The men, they were on TBS cable networks. So that factors in as well.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. I think people overlook that, and I think they want to hype the ratings. That's good. I'm a women's basketball fan. I'm a girls' high school basketball fan. I'm in that category. But it's not anything about hating it. I just say I'm not a hater. I just look at next year. The Caitlin Clark effect is gone. So how far does it fall off? I say fall off a cliff, meaning – when Caitlin Clark wasn't playing in that Elite Eight game, she got 12 million viewers, Iowa, LSU. Then when they weren't playing, Brian, it went to UConn and USC. It fell in half. That was the intro, though. Caitlin Clark brought the audience, and then it went down to 6 million for UConn, USC. That's what I mean. I think more people will watch next year as they did in the past, but it's not going to be the record.
Yeah, no, I see it the same way. We're not saying their ratings are going to fall off a cliff and be, you know, it's going to take a 250% hit like from year to year. But to expect it to just maintain, that's unrealistic. And that's not hating on women's sports. It was a huge year for women's college basketball. I loved what Dawn Staley had to say about Caitlin Clark after South Carolina beat Iowa, because Caitlin Clark meant so much to women's college basketball. It's a great place, and hopefully they can continue to grow it and grow it. But, yeah, I just don't see the same ratings at all the next season.
What do you think of the WNBA? They just announced 36 of the Indiana Fever's 40 games are going to be on national TV. So the WNBA is trying to get, okay, we better capitalize on this.
I get it. Hey, might as well try to capitalize. I think you can oversaturate the market. I don't know the best way to go about that. That seems to be overkill to me. But you could argue it both ways. Would you rather underserve the public or overserve them? One of my buddies, Mike Mr. Freakin' Zancelli, one of my friends in Albany, New York, one of my radio stops, his philosophy on dating, Nate, was always leave them wanting more, is what he would always say. And could it be something similar with the WNBA and Caitlin Clark, where think of it from that perspective, where maybe you want to have, you know, a lesser number of games that are nationally televised? Some people would say that's crazy, but I think that's a tough needle to thread, right? Like, I don't know exactly the right number of games, but that to me seems like overkill, where I don't know how special it's going to be on a game-to-game basis if almost all of her games are on national TV.
Brian Noe on tonight, Fox Sports Radio national host here on the Nate Brown Show on Fox Sports Rapid City. Let's go to the men's side. How surprised? I just got a guy on from Arkansas Rivals talking Calipari getting introduced today as the head coach for the Arkansas Razorbacks. What did you think of that when that popped?
That's pretty crazy, huh? I didn't see that one coming. And Cal's going to spin it and say all the great things of, hey, it's a great opportunity, and they just need a new voice. And he took a pay cut. Like, he's making – this is first world problems, but he's taking $1.5 million pay cut every single year. He's making $1.5 million less at Arkansas than he was at Kentucky. He basically got fired without getting fired at Kentucky, because he wanted to have an extension. They said no, and then he went elsewhere, and Kentucky gets out of that buyout. So good for them. I just think, look, that's a big get for Arkansas. If you compare those two schools historically, Kentucky has way richer of a history than Arkansas does. So it's funny how Kentucky looks at Cal like, oh, my gosh, thank goodness this bum is out of here. And Arkansas is like, this is amazing. This might be the best thing that's ever happened to us. You know, go back to the Nolan Richardson 1994 days. You know, they don't have the same history. So that's got to feel good for Cal. And that's got to be part of it, where it's like, holy cow, it's nice to be appreciated again instead of people just talking trash like I'm the biggest bum on earth. I think Cal, all things considered, where it really went wrong, if you think about this, Nate, to get to four Final Fours, to win a championship in 15 years, there are a lot of Kentucky fans that say anybody's better. Hey, let me throw a name at you. Billy Gillespie. How did that go? Okay,
yes.
Like, buckle up if that's what you're in store for going into the next era after Cal. But what really went wrong for Cal was when he had the undefeated season going in 2015. If he was able to finish that off, we would look at his career at Kentucky over 15 years, two championships, one undefeated season. We'd look at that as a smashing success. But because it's been one championship and the last 3 years of just complete failures in the tournament, a lot of people look at this like it was a colossal failure. I don't look at it the same way. I just know it's a big get for Arkansas, and be careful for what you wish for at Kentucky, because you don't know the next guy coming through the door could be better. I'll leave that possibility open. Could be worse, and it seems like most fans don't even entertain that possibility.
Now, they aren't going to get him, I don't think, but Danny Hurley, I mean, that would be the guy. Like, hey, we got to go get him. I mean, the way he coached UConn and the whole thing, it was surgical all season long, and he just picked everybody apart, and he had great players. So they're not going to get him, but would you even consider that if you're Dan Hurley from UConn to Kentucky?
I wouldn't. He's got a great thing going at UConn. He's got a machine there. Why would you go to Kentucky? Just so, you know, you can put yourself in the line of fire immediately. Like, you have to build that program up. You've got it going at UConn. Why not? You've got your name all over that UConn program. It's a complete machine right now. So, no, I wouldn't consider that. If anything, I would just use it as leverage to get more money out of UConn if I'm Danny Hurley. But sure, Kentucky would be crazy not to make that call. I think Dan Hurley would be crazy to take that gig, though.
Last one, NFL going to Brazil, Brian. No, you love talking ball. The NFL's going to Brazil, Eagles, Packers, Friday night as well. A high school football night in South Dakota, but we're going NFL on a Friday night. What do you think about going to Brazil?
I love it because all like the antitrust laws and what's going on with high school football. This is like the only time they could do it, basically, is play on a Friday. They have the Black Friday game that was last year. It was the Dolphins and Jets. But it was early enough in the day where they snuck that one in there. God bless the NFL, man. If they can just shoehorn ball into any day of the week, we got a doubleheader on Christmas Day, on Wednesday, you know. Gotta love them, man. It's like they act like they are down to their last nickel, and they just got to make something happen where they can make some money. But I'm up for it, man. Hey, week one. We get the Thursday night opener, and then we get a little São Paulo action in Brazil and all. Yeah, wow. I'm all for it. And I'll be laying the points because the Packers are a trendy pick, and they're going to fall flat on their face this season.
Wow, Nate. Early pick. Wow, early pick from Brian Noe on the Nate Brown Show tonight. Fox Sports Radio national host. Brian, always good to talk to you, man. Thanks a lot.
Man, always good talking to you, Nate. A little basketball and ball hybrid. I go ball for football. I don't know how you get down, but in any event, shout out to you and the Black Hills, man.
I appreciate it. Brian Noe on tonight, live, Fox Sports Radio national host. Follow him on Twitter if you're not, at The Noe Show. Brian Noe on the Nate Brown Show tonight. One of our favorites back in on a Wednesday. What do I think about the NFL to Brazil? I'll get into that later. I saw one of the questions from my buddy Chris. And today, it is five questions from Chris. Do you know that? He's been waiting. I've been out sick. Now I'm back. He sent me five questions, so I got to hit him today. Five questions from Chris coming up later in the program. Let's talk Masters with a golf pro. He's at Elkhorn Ridge. I'm going to get his pick for the Masters. Starts tomorrow. Mike Mendelson live next.
You're listening to The Nate Brown Show.
The sun is shining and riding season has begun. Hi, this is Kelly Rank from Black Hills Harley-Davidson. Kick off riding season in the seat of a new or new-to-you Harley-Davidson motorcycle. I'm fully stocked with all the colors of the new 2024 Street Glide and Road Glide, plus the 2024 custom builds are starting to land on our showroom floor. Get ready for riding season with free installation of fresh rubbers during Rubber Awareness Month in our service department. See our Motor Clothes department for free helmet inspections, or trade in your old helmet and get $25 off a new Harley-Davidson helmet all month long. Come start riding season at Black Hills Harley-Davidson in Rapid City.
Now through April 30th at Pumps Tire Service, get up to $100 instant savings. Save $70 when you purchase four eligible Bridgestone tires, or $60 when you purchase four eligible Firestone tires. Plus, get $30 off when your purchase is made on your Pumps Tire Service credit card. Wait, there's more! Purchase four eligible tires and save an additional $40 off installation. Hurry! Offers end April 30th. Pumps. We know tires and service. You should know Pumps. Subject to credit approval. See store for complete details or visit PumpsTire.com.
Here's your Fox Sports Rapid City forecast. A wind advisory continues until 7 p.m. tonight. Lows level off around 30 tonight under clear skies. Winds out of the northwest 10 to 20 miles per hour. Daytime highs approaching 57. Tomorrow, mainly sunny skies. Lows dip down to about 33. Tomorrow night, mainly clear skies. That's your forecast on the Black Hills Sports Station, Fox Sports Rapid City. Currently 49.
Need somewhere to go for a quick bite to eat for lunch? Murphy's has you covered with a half sandwich and soup lunch special, plus daily specials to get you fueled up and ready for the rest of the day. Meet and eat for lunch at Murphy's, a Rapid City icon.
Nearly 150 years ago, Americans didn't race across the plains to settle. They pioneered. They toiled and ground the land into the world we know today. Creating opportunities, not just for themselves, but for future generations. Don't settle. Pioneer. Pioneer Bank and Trust. Local.
Member FDIC.
Hey, this is Rob Parker from The Odd Couple. Don't miss our show weeknights from 6 to 8 p.m. right here on Fox Sports Rapid City. And now we'll send you back to Rapid City Sports Talk Show to Nate Brown.
Your sports, your show. Welcome back in. South Dakota Sports Talk Show live weekdays 4 to 6 on Fox Sports Rapid City. Listen on the radio side, 106.7 FM, 1150 AM, 5 states strong. On the AM side, you can get us anywhere. Stream us all the time on your phone, foxsportsrapidcity.com. foxsportsrapidcity.com. Jerry Brewer's coming up, national columnist for the Washington Post. We'll get into a lot of good stuff with Jerry. Covered the Final Four in Phoenix. Jerry Brewer on tap. East River meets West River tonight. SDPB Sports, longtime broadcaster Craig Maddox still ahead. And the Drive at 5 featuring 5 questions from Chris. A busy Wednesday show. Glad to be back. Hey, you know what we got? Masters Week. The Masters starting tomorrow. I thought we got to get a golf expert on, right? So let's take a look at this thing. He's the pro at Elkhorn Ridge in Spearfish. Talking Masters with Mike Mendelson, golf pro at Elkhorn Ridge here on the Nate Brown Show. Mike, good to have you on for the first time. How are you?
I'm doing great, Nate. Thanks for having me on. Listen to the show a lot, and appreciate you covering all the local sports in the area.
Well, I appreciate that. So I wanted to go Masters, and I said, okay, you're the golf pro at Elkhorn Ridge, so I'm going to get your feel on this. First, the thing that jumped out to me, Scottie Scheffler's like the favorite, and when people are looking at who's going to win this, to me it's so hard to pick the winner. Are you surprised he's as heavy favorite as he is?
I mean, not really. Like, especially, like, just, you know, I mean, he's finished in the top 10 in, you know, all of his last tournaments. Like, everything that he seems to play in, he's always has a chance to win it. I think that's what, why he's such a strong favorite. And I think if you're, you know, it's hard, you know, in a Masters pool or anything like that, if you're in one of those, it's hard not to pick him. I mean, he's always in the hunt. Like, you know, he makes the cuts. He's always in the top 10. So, it would be very hard for someone to not pick him. Rory's the next there. He's, you know, plus 1,000, and Scheffler's plus 325. So I think he's pretty much the lock pick there.
Okay, so I'm going to ask you, as you look at the game, as you watch golfers lately, as we get started here, who do you think's in good position? Would you go Scheffler? How do you feel about the field?
Yeah, I mean, it's a really, anything that's in the Masters, you know, it's tough. I mean, you're looking to pick someone that has played that tournament well and played before. You know, there's only been three players that have ever won it in their first appearance. So you're looking for someone that's played there before and, you know, had some success. Like, I really do think Scheffler's going to be in the mix. The LIV Golf thing also throws a whole nother aspect into it. So, you know, you got Koepka and Joaquin Niemann, some of those guys that you don't really know what's going to happen because, you know, Koepka hasn't really been playing good on LIV this year, but he seems to always find it for the majors. A couple guys that I kind of been targeting in some of mine, with a little better odds are Sahith Theegala. You know, I think he's been playing really well this year. He's played the Masters before. I think he'll have a good showing. And then, you know, a guy like in the plus 7,000 range that I really like, is Russell Henley. He's had some really good finishes of late, and he has a pretty good track record at the Masters. So those are some guys a little deeper in the field that I like.
Golf pro at Elkhorn Ridge, Mike Mendelson talking Masters on the Nate Brown Show on Fox Sports Rapid City. So Tiger's going to try and do this thing. What do you say about Tiger going into the weekend? People are looking at, like, he hasn't been able to finish some rounds, and we want to watch Tiger. Is he going to make it into the weekend?
You know, that's a really interesting question. It's been kind of a mixed bag for him. You know, if he can play, like, I think, like, the Masters is probably one of his best opportunities to, you know, make the cut and make a little better run at it. I mean, no one knows that golf course as well as he does. You know, I mean, a lot of the younger players try to play in practice rounds with him to get some of his knowledge and course knowledge and stuff like that. So, you know, I think for him to, you know, make a run a little bit, make the cut, I do think he probably can make the cut there. It's a tough walk for 4 days for him for sure, but I mean, nobody knows that golf course as good as he does. I don't know if he can. You know, it's hard to say if he'll win another tournament. Like, you know, Augusta would be, like, that chance, I think. Like, there's only a few courses, I think, that he would be able to really compete anymore, and Augusta is definitely one of those.
Is this your favorite, Mike? Is this it right here, or tell me why?
You know, this is definitely a golfer's dream, right? I think it's everybody's favorite major. Like, even, you know, as a young kid when I really didn't play golf a whole lot, like, I was, you know, you always kind of just watch the Masters. I didn't start playing golf till I was a little bit older, in high school and stuff, but I always, you know, it was one that we always had on TV, even as, you know, a family that didn't golf a whole lot, like, when I was younger. I got into the business a little bit later, but it's always been one of those that you always just have watched. You know, it's a big sporting event. It's always on the grand stage, you know. And I did have the opportunity to go to the Masters in 2015, and it's, you know, everything is advertised. It's just a big week for golf, and it's always nice. I mean, this is the first year since I moved to South Dakota that our golf course will actually be open on Masters week. So
I like it.
Yeah, it's a nice deal where I think it kicks off our golf season. Everybody's excited. But, yeah, it is my favorite major, and, you know, it's a great week. You know, you get off the college basketball and then, you know, into the Masters, and then we got, you know, some NBA playoffs and the Major League Baseball going. So it's a good time of year for sports, for sure.
Mike Mendelson on tonight. He's the golf pro at Elkhorn Ridge here on the Nate Brown Show on Fox Sports Rapid City, talking Masters. You mentioned it a little bit, so I'm going to get into it. For people that have kind of fallen out of this thing, you got the LIV Tour, you got the PGA Tour. People have said, can these coexist, or are we going to have some type of marriage some way? What do you say?
I really do think it's so weird, like, as a golf fan, like, you know, I don't blame anyone for going to LIV. I mean, you know, people have to do what's best for them and, you know, whatever they think. But I do think at some time that there's going to have to be something. I mean, those guys have to get some points so they're eligible to play in some tournaments and things like that. It's hard to, you know, it's a really kind of bizarre time in professional golf, I think, you know, just with the two tours. You know, even when you're looking at these things, like just watching golf on TV, sometimes there's two tournaments on. And, you know, I've always, like, kind of preferred watching the, you know, PGA Tour. I have watched a little LIV, but I do think it would be better for golf if they were somewhat mixed together. I don't know how that's going to ever roll out, but, you know, I do think it would be better for the fans.
It's complex. Yeah. No, I'm with you on that. It's complex. I think people have a hard time following it, the whole thing. So do you have a favorite golfer you're rooting for, Mike, this week? Who are you rooting for?
Rooting for, you know, I mean, you know, I'm a big Tiger fan. I'd like to see him have a good week. You know, like I said, I kind of am interested in a couple of those guys a little further down the list. You know, it'd be nice to see, you know, I wouldn't mind seeing Rory, you know, have a good shot at it. You know, it'd be neat for him to get the career Grand Slam. But I'm also really pulling for, like, you know, someone. I put a little wager at the 10 Lizzie on Russell Henley, so I'd like to see that come through.
Okay, so. I believe that. That's probably who you're rooting for. He's the golf pro at Elkhorn Ridge here on the Nate Brown Show. Mike Mendelson, their golf season getting underway, elkhornridgeresort.com. Mike, good to have you, man. Thanks a lot.
Hey, Nate, I really appreciate it. Thanks for having me.
Yep, have a great week. Mike Mendelson, the golf pro at Elkhorn Ridge here on the Nate Brown Show. elkhornridgeresort.com is their golf season's underway. Great course in Spearfish. Really, really nice course. Okay, so Scottie Scheffler's the big favorite. So that's one thing I don't really place sports bets on is golf. I mean, I know a lot of you guys love that, and you pick this golfer and that golfer. Man, it is tough. I did that a little bit, and I'm like, man, I've never won, never even come close to winning. Scottie Scheffler's the favorite. And he's the biggest favorite since Greg Norman at the Masters in 1989. Kind of give you a perspective. Scottie Scheffler just been on fire. The biggest favorite since Greg Norman was at the Masters in 1989. Masters starts tomorrow. We're into the drive at 5 tonight. And it's 5 questions from Chris on a Wednesday. Good ones, Chris. I'll get the answers out next.
This is South Dakota's sports talk show, The Nate Brown Show, on FoxSportsRapidCity.com and live on 106.7 FM and 1150 AM Fox Sports Rapid City.
The wait is over. Ensemble Entry Doors, exclusively from Renewal by Anderson, have arrived with an incredible offer. Secure, timeless style, elegant features, customized countless ways with the legendary quality of Renewal by Anderson. Right now, you get 20% off every Ensemble Entry Door. No money down, no interest, and no payments for 12 months. No payments for a year. Please scan the QR code on your screen or visit rbarapidcity.com now to book your free estimate. Ensemble Entry Doors, the wait is over.
We are number one, so you can always be their number one. Black Hills Surgical Hospital and Black Hills Orthopedic and Spine Center. The number one hospital in the nation for major orthopedic surgery.
At First Gold in Deadwood, makes dining out delicious and affordable. Every Wednesday from 11 till 8 p.m., enjoy traditional wings for a buck or boneless wings for 50 cents, served with your pick of 12 different sauces. Thursday, it's two for $20 burger night. Big and fresh burgers with your choice of side. The Horseshoe Restaurant proudly serves breakfast all day. And from 7 a.m. till 1 p.m., you can add one giant homemade pancake to your meal for only $2.99. The Horseshoe Restaurant at First Gold Gaming Resort in Deadwood.
KIMM Rapid City and K294BT Rapid City, the Black Hills Sports Station, 106.7 FM and 1150 AM, Fox Sports Rapid City.
We're all going somewhere, going higher, faster, farther, going in new directions, to new places. At Monument Health, we keep going so you can keep going. We're dedicated to advanced orthopedic care with the latest innovations, technology, expertise, and treatment. So keep exploring, keep making memories, keep going with Monument Health as your partner. Learn more at monument.health/orthopedics.
Hi, this is David Brenneman with Coldwell Banker, Black Hills Legacy in Rapid City. With today's home values, right now could be a great time to sell your home. The Black Hills housing market is competitive, and I would love to help you get top dollar for your home. I have been selling real estate and attracting buyers in Rapid City for nearly 20 years. When it comes to buying or selling, experience matters. If you're thinking of selling your current home, let me put my expertise to work for you. Just Google David Brenneman, Coldwell Banker, list it, sell it, and move on. With me, David Brenneman, Coldwell Banker.
Building projects can be complex. The risks are great and time is money. Consolidated Construction of Rapid City simplifies the process by being your advocate, guiding you through funding, design, and construction. They manage the players and the schedule and marry the design to your budget so you get the most for your investment. They promise an energizing experience before, during, and after construction. It's not enough that you get a quality building. They pledge you'll experience quality every step of the way. Consolidated Construction. One call to build.
Hi, this is Dan Patrick. Remember to catch me weekday mornings from 7 until 10 a.m. right here on 106.7 FM and 1150 AM Fox Sports Rapid City. And now, back to Rapid City's sports talk show, the Nate Brown Show.
Welcome back in the Nate Brown Show, back on a Wednesday. Fox Sports Rapid City, the Black Hills Sports Station, 106.7 FM, 1150 AM, and stream us all the time, FoxSportsRapidCity.com. You can watch this show live on your phone. If you have a Twitter X account, follow us at Nate Brown Show. If you're not following the show, we appreciate that, and you can watch us live 4 to 6 at Nate Brown Show on Twitter. And YouTube channel is up live right now, The Nate Brown Show on YouTube, The Nate Brown Show YouTube. Drive at 5, brought to you by Summit Automotive Group. Just saw a new Escape on the road from Summit. Yes, when it comes to pre-owned vehicles, go take a look. They got SUVs like the Escape. They got cars, trucks. The selection's great, but that's only the start at Summit. It's car buying built around you from start to finish. Experience the Summit difference. SummitAutoGRP.com. Start there on your phone. SummitAutoGRP.com when it comes to pre-owned. Jerry Brewer's coming up. National columnist, Washington Post on the way. Craig Maddock in tonight, so a busy Drive at 5 with Craig, SDPB Sports, live from Sioux Falls. A lot to cover tonight. You know what we got to get to on a Wednesday? I was out the last 2 days sick. I mean, it was ridiculous sickness. Ridiculous. You don't want to know. But I'm back and ready, and that means it is 5 questions from Chris today. Chris, you've been waiting. Here you go. 5 questions from Chris on a Wednesday. Question number 1. Nate, the NFL announced Green Bay is going to play Philadelphia in Brazil, week 1 of the NFL season on a Friday night. Is it smart for the league to expand its footprint beyond Europe, or should the NFL focus their effort on the European market? Well, I don't know, man. They're just going every which way. Mexico City and now to Brazil. They've done the games over in London and Germany. I mean, they're just going worldwide. It's just a global thing now. The biggest thing I have there, Chris, I don't love the Friday night in the early part of the season. I mean, I know I'm a high school football fan, and we love high school football here. It's high school football Friday night early in September. And now we got Packers, Eagles as well. And it's just another one of those things that jumping on high school football a little bit. There's no sacred ground, and the NFL doesn't care, right? We all love the NFL. So you're going to go to the game Friday, and you're going to be watching the Packers and Eagles on your phone. And that's what they want to do. Brazil? I don't know. I know they love soccer. They love soccer. They're going to love American football? We'll see. Question number 2. Nate, do you think the popularity of the women's college basketball game will continue for the next few seasons, or will there be a fall-off from missing stars like Caitlin Clark and Angel Reese? Well, I'm going to put Angel Reese even in a different category, Chris. She's not even in that category with Caitlin. Caitlin's in a category by herself. End of story. And the popularity of women's college basketball has grown unbelievably, which I love it. I mean, this was exciting. I told my fifth grade basketball team, hey, go and watch Iowa try and win the national title here. And they were all rooting for Caitlin Clark and Iowa. It was just so much fun. The whole thing, it brought a smile to my face this whole run. But it will fall off next year. Not just the next few seasons. It will fall off next year. Not like end of story fall off, because the popularity has grown, so people have an interest there. But no Caitlin Clark, no record ratings. That's it. Question number 3. While still focusing on Clark, do you think the WNBA will experience meaningful growth in popularity when she gets in the league? Yes, it will. It will experience growth. How much? That's what I have my doubts with. And people say, oh, Caitlin Clark is just not big enough to draw people to WNBA. No, it's a WNBA problem. I'm going to die on this hill. The WNBA season, a summer league. Nobody's watching. Nobody's caring as much. We don't know the teams. We just don't have those stories. College basketball got us interested. Caitlin Clark got us ultra interested. Had a rivalry going. Nobody knows the Indiana Fever. Like, we have no clue. And it's on in the summer. We're going on vacations. We're running around. I think it's a WNBA problem. It will grow, but it's not going to be like unbelievable viewership and talking points on national media. It's just not. That's my guess. Question number 4. There have been only 2 pitchers in the last 2 seasons that have won 20 games in Major League Baseball. 2 pitchers last 2 seasons that have won 20. With the trend of teams pulling their starting pitchers in the 5th or sooner, are we looking at a new reality? The win-loss record for a pitcher won't be the main benchmark as what's a good season for a pitcher. I guess I hate that, Chris. I want wins and losses. I want pitchers to get on the starter to go deep and give me 7, but they just aren't doing it because of the teams are the ones that are pulling them out. So people are trying to tell me, you got to look at this number and that number, and they give me all this stuff that I was a baseball guy. I played baseball. I liked baseball. And now I got to look at all these, the whip, the that, the this, the spin, the velocity. It's like, just give me a win-loss and an ERA. Could you give me the win-loss ERA? That's what I want to know. But it is going out the window. I hate it. Question number 5. Parts of North America experienced a total eclipse on Monday. The next eclipse that comes into the 48 states, lower 48, will not happen until 2046. Nate, during that 22-year window, which of your favorite teams do you hope wins a championship? Well, that's easy, Chris. That's easy. The Denver Broncos. Not Sean Payton. He won't get us there, I have a feeling. I have my doubts. But I got to go with the Broncos winning another Super Bowl title in the next 22 years, you think? Chris, he said he went to the eclipse. You went and looked at the eclipse, Chris. What was I doing? I was sick. I had my own eclipse in my room. Let me tell you. Anyway, that's enough on that. Five questions from Chris. In the books. And Jerry Brewer, national columnist for the Washington Post. Great guest. Next.
Did you miss an interview or great segment on The Nate Brown Show? Just find The Nate Brown Show podcast and listen wherever you download your podcasts.
The sun is shining and riding season has begun. Hi, this is Kelly Rank from Black Hills Harley-Davidson. Kick off riding season in the seat of a new or new-to-you Harley-Davidson motorcycle. I'm fully stocked with all the colors of the new 2024 Street Glide and Road Glide, plus the 2024 custom builds are starting to land on our showroom floor. Get ready for riding season with free installation of fresh rubbers during Rubber Awareness Month in our service department. See our Motor Coast department for free helmet inspections or trade in your old helmet and get $25 off a new Harley-Davidson helmet all month long. Come start riding season at Black Hills Harley-Davidson in Rapid City.
Ready to be part of something big? Meet the Rapid City Sports Commission, the powerhouse behind sports in Rapid City. The commission focuses on bringing regional and national tournaments, supporting homegrown events, and creating opportunities for our kids. But it's not just games, it's a win-win for all of us. Youth sports fuel our economy. Hosting events in Rapid City means out-of-town families shop, dine, and stay with us, which boosts sales tax revenues, too. To get in on the action, visit rcsportscommission.com, where we're all about the hustle.
Whether you run the race, make the catch, cast a line, pitch a tent, or just look good doing it, Shields Rapid City has your gear. From athletic clothing from your favorite team, cold weather gear to keep you warm, to the best camping selection this side of the Black Hills, and the most stylish and functional women's outerwear and footwear, Shields has the widest selection of the best brands in the business. So when you're ready to get out, get in the game, or get going, get to Shields. Shields, we're right there with you at Rushmore Crossing in Rapid City.
Celebrate spring with a new professional-grade GMC at Spearfish GMC. Save up to $7,000 on select new 2024 Sierra 1500s or get $3,250 cash back and 1.9 APR. See us for offer details. Up to $2,250 bonus cash on terrains in stock or 0.9 APR and no payments for 90 days. As always, your best deal is here. Spearfish GMC Cadillac. Online at spearfishmotors.com.
Hi, this is Jeremy with Jerry's Cakes and Donuts, inviting you to kickstart your morning by dropping by and grabbing some fresh donuts. I want to thank you for voting us the best in the Black Hills. We're up early, making your favorite donuts, so stop by and bring some to the office. Everybody loves Jerry's Cakes and Donuts, and we love you, so stop by, get a great selection to brighten up your day. Serving Rapid City for over 40 years, Jerry's Cakes and Donuts at 109 East Omaha, and remember to like Jerry's on Facebook for some great giveaways.
Here's your Fox Sports Rapid City forecast. A wind advisory continues until 7 p.m. tonight. Lows level off around 30 tonight under clear skies. Winds out of the northwest 10 to 20 miles per hour. Daytime highs approaching 57. Tomorrow, mainly sunny skies. Lows dip down to about 33. Tomorrow night, mainly clear skies. That's your forecast on the Black Hills Sports Station, Fox Sports Rapid City. Right now, 46.
We all know life's busy, and if you get sick, you can get behind pretty quick. That's where Black Hills Urgent Care comes in. No appointments needed, no long waits, just fast, affordable care to get you feeling better quicker. Black Hills Urgent Care has two locations in Rapid City on Haynes Avenue and Mountain View Road. You can simply check in online at bhucare.com. That's with the letter U, bhucare.com. When you need care, see the team at Black Hills Urgent Care, the faster way to get better.
Live from the Anytime Auto Sales Service and Details Studio, sales, service, and recreation, this is Fox Sports Rapid City.
Welcome back in. The Nate Brown Show, driven by Spearfish Motors, your home for the new 2024 Cadillacs and GMCs in the Black Hills. Locally owned new car and truck dealership. There's not many of those left. That matters. Stop at 1910 North Main in Spearfish. Look for the big American flag. You've got Spearfish Motors and the lot full of the new Yukons, GMC Sierra pickups, the GMC Canyon Terrain. Great specials right now. Financing. Spearfish GMC Cadillac. We are professional grade. Start online at spearfishmotors.com. Jerry Brewer back on the Nate Brown Show, Fox Sports Rapid City, national columnist, WashingtonPost.com. Jerry, good to have you back on. How are you?
I'm doing great, Nate. How are you?
I'm doing good, man. I'm better, okay? I'm back in the swing today. I have to ask you about the Final Four, the men's national championship. I want to get your read on UConn winning back-to-back, and people are saying, man, this is a big deal. And you said Dan Hurley is the best coach in the game right now. Why?
Right at this very minute, yes. I would say so, because I think that he understands this time maybe better than some of the other coaches do. I think we're in a period where guys are starting to get out, right? Like Coach K, maybe the best to ever do it, decided like this was the time for him to leave. And Roy Williams, Jay Wright a few years before that. You're seeing guys like John Calipari really start to struggle and not understanding like what this time is with the transfer portal. How do you mix high school recruiting in? How many transfers do you take? How do you develop players? UConn is great at developing their own. They use the transfer portal, but they don't do it excessively. They are great at recruiting players that are really good for their program. And I give Dan Hurley a tremendous amount of credit, because at heart, he's more of a grinded-out defensive coach. But he said, you know what? In order to gain a real advantage, I have to loosen up, and I have to make our team more offensive-centric. He's done that. They're one of the most unselfish, brilliant kind of offenses. They utilize NBA kind of like one-on-one matchups. They move without the ball incredibly well. They understand spacing on the floor better than most college teams. They are complete. I didn't know, Nate, at a time like this, that you could have a back-to-back champion because of so much roster overhaul. But UConn is one that they've been able to not have guys that they wanted to keep leave in mass numbers, and they've been able to kind of create an identity for their program. And I'm going to tell you this right now, this isn't the last national championship that Dan Hurley's going to win at Connecticut.
So I look at him, I say, unbelievable coach. I've watched him this tournament. They win the last 12 games last year and this year in the tournament by 13 points or more. I mean, it's unbelievable. So it wasn't even close in these games. So it's been outstanding. Then I watch him. Man, he's fiery. And this is just a side note, right, Jerry? So unbelievably fiery. He's talking to Zach Edey. He pushes a player of his own live in the game, and then he, like, forgets that he does it. What should we think about his persona? Are you there? Do I have you? Maybe? No? Did I lose him? Jerry Brewer, come back. Maybe Jerry Brewer will come back. Maybe he won't come back. I'll give you one more. Okay. Let's see if we can get him back. I lost Jerry. He was there, and then he was gone. By the way, with Dan Hurley, you guys know what I'm talking about. I mean, he's just unbelievable. I don't know about you, but, man, when I coach fifth-grade girls basketball, I'm not even close to, anyway, how Dan Hurley's acting on the sideline. He pushes his player to have him run a play live in the game and then gets a turnover because of it. And he doesn't even remember that it happened. He doesn't even remember that it went on. He goes, what's going on? By the way, and then he's talking to Zach Edey as he's going to the timeout. I think that's just one of the things that Dan Hurley will be remembered for. He'll be remembered more for just unbelievable efficiency. And Jerry talked about it. We'll see if we can get Jerry back, talk more college basketball. He covered the Final Four. Let's see if we can track him down. Hang on.
This is the Nate Brown Show.
Attention, please. The new loaded cheesy ranch sticks at Pizza Ranch are loaded with flavor. Skillet crust, melty cheese, herbs, spices, and now up to two of your favorite toppings like pepperoni, sausage, jalapenos, and bacon. You've really got to get a load of these. Like, literally, get a whole load of them. Pizza Ranch, everyone's favorite buffet.
Stop into your local Pizza Ranch with two Rapid City locations. Their buffet open daily, 11 to 8, and order online at pizzaranch.com.
Get ready to swing into spring with the $100,000 Easy Street Grand Prize Giveaway. Tin Lizzie Gaming Resort has teamed up with Elkhorn Ridge Golf Club to give away a premier golf package every Saturday in April. The package includes a couple's membership to Elkhorn Ridge, $3,000 pro shop credit, a season-long golf cart rental, and much more. Elkhorn Ridge offers a full resort experience with tennis courts, a pool, restaurant, bar, and one of the nicest golf courses in the area. Take your golf game to the next level with Tin Lizzie Gaming Resort on Historic Main Street in Deadwood.
Live from the Anytime Auto Sales Service and Details Studio, sales, service, and recreation, this is Fox Sports Rapid City.
Okay, I think I've got him back. We're right back into it on the Nate Brown Show with Jerry Brewer, national sports columnist, WashingtonPost.com. And we're just talking Dan Hurley, UConn on the men's side, Jerry. While I've got you back, I want to go to the women's side now. So the men's national championship gets 15 million viewers. The women get almost 19 million. One's on ABC, the women. I think that matters. The men on TBS, TNT, and True. So I think that matters. But it's really the Caitlin Clark effect to me. What did you think of those numbers, women passing men for the first time?
Well, I expected it. I think the women's game over the last 2-3 years has been far more compelling of a narrative arc than the men's game, and then you had the Caitlin Clark effect on top of that. I think it's we want to get to know our athletes, and so when players are jumping from team to team and jumping to the NBA after 1 year, going to the G League, it makes it really hard for the men's college product. And in women's basketball, I mean, with Caitlin, you got to see her for 4 years. With Paige Beckers, because she's going to take the COVID year, you'll see her for 5. Rivalries are developed. The fact that we got Iowa LSU again, that drew such a huge Elite Eight TV number, and so all those. It's just a great moment for women's basketball and women's sports in general, and I hope it's. Abolishing some of the stereotypes and myths about that game or about women's games in general. The product has always been compelling to me. Now when you start to add in evolutionary-type basketball players, and after Caitlin, now we've got Juju Watkins, who will only be a sophomore. And I mentioned Beckers before. The game's in really good shape. I don't know if they're going to get $19 million for next year's national title game.
Right.
I think this is a real growth moment that's going to continue.
My question of the day to my audience, Jerry, I think it's a tough one. I said, is there going to be a bigger increase for the WNBA or a bigger decrease for women's college basketball with the Caitlin Clark effect?
I think there's going to be. I think it'll be a bigger increase for WNBA. The WNBA is a hard league, and I know like Diana Taurasi like got people going when she was talking about reality is coming for all the rookies, including Caitlin. It's an ownery league. It's not a league that you just step in and dominate. Candace Parker is the only one that I can remember who came in right away and was MVP. They stay around for a long time. It's a physical game, ownery competitors. We've never seen like a 30-point scorer for their career, like a Jordan-like 30-point scorer in the WNBA, which is partly because they played 40 minutes instead of 48. And so the question becomes, like, what is Caitlin? Like, would it be a letdown if Caitlin averaged 17 points and 8 assists? Right, like maybe it just depends on how she does it. But I think I've thought about this quite a bit, Nate. In that, like, I want to make some parallels between Magic and Bird in the NBA, and possibly Caitlin, and if a true rival starts to bud for her. But then also you've got Asia Wilson and Breanna Stewart as the two best players in the WNBA, and friendly rivals. I think there could be this moment, and Magic and Bird, you know, it starts in college. College is an immensely more popular game than the NBA at that moment, and then Magic and Bird kind of transformed it. I think there's a chance for, like, what you've seen in women's college basketball to start to transfer over to the pros, but it's going to be hard, and it's going to take a lot, and it's we're not conditioned as a society to watch a 40-game basketball season in the summer bleeding into fall that plays right. Its playoff games right against the NFL calendar.
Right, right.
They've got some challenges against each other, but if Caitlin somehow catches fire and continues to be appointment viewing, if she comes to the W and is shooting logo threes and has 30 and 40 point nights, maybe not with regularity, but they still pop up and she throws all these highlight passes and all this, it's going to catch attention. So that buzz, I mean, you've already seen the ticket prices go up in WNBA arenas, and they're going to be playing toward the packed houses and all that. If that Indiana Fever team, which already has Aaliyah Boston on it, if they can somehow get good quickly, and that Las Vegas Aces team is really one of the best teams in women's basketball history. If you sort of have a young versus kind of old and established type of rivalry that takes place quickly in the WNBA, I think that could be a moment for that league, a moment of growth. Maybe not exponential like it was in college, but I tend to think that her effect lifted, I think, women's college basketball to a place where the floor is a lot higher, and maybe they don't reach the ceiling that they did under Caitlin, but the floor is still going to be really high.
Yeah.
And then I think her effect is going to carry over into increased interest and attention and revenue for the WNBA.
I think it's intriguing. I do. I don't know how far that's going to go, but Caitlin Clark effect's unbelievable. Jerry Brewer on tonight, WashingtonPost.com. Last one, Jerry. John Calipari goes to Arkansas. If you were betting, will John Calipari make Arkansas a national contender?
Yes, he will. I don't think the game is passing by. I think some of his failures the last 3 or 4 years at Kentucky, going to a new place, I think that's going to energize him. You saw Eric Musselman got the Razorbacks to a couple of Elite Eights. They were just right knocking on the door, a couple of Elite Eights, a Sweet 16. They were knocking on the door of making a Final Four. He was recruiting well, both all the transfers that he takes and getting high school players to come to Fayetteville. Arkansas is going to be good under John Calipari. He's got to win in the tournament, though. Like that's the big thing. And I think some of this was just sort of kind of just random, just random tournament stuff that he had some bad luck, as opposed to something that's just fatally wrong with John Calipari. But now he gets a chance to do it somewhere else, take some of the pressure off. He's going to be great. I mean, I'm stunned to see him in those Arkansas colors. It's going to be weird as hell when he plays Kentucky, maybe even twice a year, and he goes back to Rupp Arena. But I think that was a good strong hire from Arkansas. And me being a native Kentuckian, I am so fascinated by who steps up and takes this University of Kentucky job, if they're able to get one of their high-profile picks, or if some kind of reality hits them about just how difficult a job it can be on a coach.
I did not know you're a Kentucky guy. Okay, Jerry Brewer, good to have him. Perfect guest to have. National columnist tonight, WashingtonPost.com. He's on Twitter, X @JerryBrewer. Jerry, always great. Thanks a lot.
Oh, anytime, man.
Thanks a lot. Jerry Brewer on tonight, one of our favorite guests. Great stuff. WashingtonPost.com, national sports columnist here on the Nate Brown Show on Fox Sports Rapid City. Now let's go East River meets West River. We're just popping on a Wednesday. East River meets West River, Sioux Falls, and Rapid City get together with Craig Maddock, SDPB Sports. What does he say about this new sport growing in popularity for girls in high school around the country? Will we ever see it in South Dakota? That's next.
From high school to college to the pros, this is the Nate Brown Show on 106.7 FM and 1150 AM Fox Sports Rapids.
The wait is over. Ensemble Entry Doors, exclusively from Renewal by Anderson, have arrived with an incredible offer. Secure, timeless style, elegant features, customized countless ways with the legendary quality of Renewal by Anderson. Right now, you get 20% off every Ensemble Entry Door. No money down, no interest, and no payments for 12 months. No payments for a year. Please scan the QR code on your screen or visit rbarapidcity.com now to book your free estimate. Ensemble Entry Doors, the wait is over.
We are number one, so you can always be their number one. Black Hills Surgical Hospital and Black Hills Orthopedic and Spine Center. The number one hospital in the nation for major orthopedic surgery.
This is Dr. Dan Jensen at Physio. We want to be your trusted partner for physical therapy, athlete development, and sports rehab. As the official strength and conditioning partners for Stevens, Central, Douglas, and the Rapid City Rush, our team at Physio is building the best athletes in the Black Hills. If you have an athlete in the family, we offer long-term athlete development at affordable prices for middle and high school students. We also have the only board-certified sports PT in Rapid City. At our brand new facility, Physio is ready to help you perform at your best. One-on-one physical therapy, athlete development, and sports rehab, all at one place. Get started at bhphysio.com.
Hi, this is Shane Griffin. I'm part of the Will Dixon Real Estate team. I know what it's like looking for a new home or your family's first home in the Black Hills. That's why I specialize in helping the first-time home buyer make their dream of home ownership a reality. I'm also a veteran, and I'm proud to serve military members in the Black Hills. Our team at Will Dixon Real Estate has great relationships with local lenders. Whether you're looking at buying or selling, just Google Shane Griffin Keller Williams. That's Shane Griffin at Keller Williams to take your first step into your new home.
Live from the Anytime Auto Sales Service and Details Studio. Sales, service, and recreation. This is Fox Sports Rapid City.
Welcome back in. It is time for East River meets West River. Sioux Falls meets Rapid City. Every week on the Nate Brown Show, it is Craig Maddock live. SDPB Sports, longtime broadcaster. And he's here on the Nate Brown Show on Fox Sports Rapid City. Craig Maddock in tonight. Craig, good to have you. How are you?
Yeah, I'm doing good. Thanks, Nate. Hope things are well with you.
Well, they're better. I was sick the last 2 days. Okay.
Yeah, well, I know. It's tough to keep a good man down, but so, you've bounced back beautifully.
Well, you could say that. You could say that. I'm here. Let me just say that. By the way, I've got to ask you this. It's a high school story that just came out today from the NFHS. The NFHS executive director sent out a story today, I guess a letter you would say, and she said this sport is the next emerging high school sport for girls. 28 states will now have it sanctioned or is a pilot program over half of the country. Flag football. And Craig Maddock says what?
Well I thought, well, just a couple of years ago, the fastest growing sport was actually high school bowling. And I thought, would that take shape in South Dakota? But when you take a look at what we have already, and certainly South Dakota, because of the geographics and the size of our state, we have pretty much maxed out, I think, when you look at girls' sports, you know, in the fall with volleyball, and you got your tennis and golf, and you have cheer and dance,
yeah,
and soccer, and then, and of course, wintertime with basketball. and then, of course, in the spring with track and field. And I mean, I just can't see us adding and softball. Did I mention softball and track in the spring? I just don't see how we can add any more, mainly because there's not enough athletes to go around.
Okay, interesting. Montana's looking at adding it, state next door. Colorado as well. They're looking at sanctioning high school girls flag football this next year. And there are states that have done state championships and the whole thing. Alaska, Florida, Alabama, some of these states. So Southern, Northern. I look at it.
Bigger states, no doubt.
Yeah, and Alaska is not like super populated, but so they're making a run at it.
Do they play those games on an iceberg up there?
come on now. You got to be tough to play flag football in Alaska. Let me tell you. By the way,
yes.
I asked, do you ever think we'll ever see it sanctioned here? 79% of my audience says no, not enough interest. 21% say yes, if you offered it, girls would play it. Here's how I compare it. I don't like never saying never, but did we ever think girls' high school wrestling would get as popular as it is today? To me, I didn't think so.
No. Plus, you know, I forgot, too, the wrestling. I think wrestling right now is the fastest-growing girls' sport in the country. You know, and bowling was out there. Bowling was out there because it is – it's not like gymnastics where you got to buy all this equipment. I mean, for bowling across the country, a fairly simple sport that didn't cost a lot of money. And flag football wouldn't cost a lot of money either.
Yep.
Think about it.
Yep. So you're siding with, you don't think you'll see it in South Dakota anytime soon.
No, I don't think so, because it's a numbers game. I mean, here in Sioux Falls, you know, out at the Pentagon, or the right across the street from the Pentagon, there is flag football leagues, and there are a number of girls who are involved with that.
Okay.
It's hard for me to see it happening on a statewide level.
Okay, I talked to Dan Sortos, as we both know Dan, executive director of the Activities Association, on my show last week, and he said there are now two schools that wanted them to start the process of seeing if we can sanction high school baseball. It's been a never-ending topic with you and me.
Mm-hmm.
High school baseball, over 50 schools are playing club. So now with this process getting started, do you think we'll see that eventually?
Well, they're going to have to change. Legion baseball is going to have to change. High school baseball is going to have to change. They're going to have to be in bed together. And if they're willing to do that, I could see sanctioned baseball. But until the Legion program accepts the length of the season of where high school baseball would be, and you know, I'm speaking specifically of post-22, that, you know, if the Legion baseball can wait until after the high school baseball season is done, then there's a chance it could happen.
Okay, but you have to think that East River schools, which do use the high school baseball season a lot for their, and then they lead into Legion. If there's enough East River schools, wouldn't there be? I mean, Dan said, hey, a couple of schools, you know, sent this to us. They said, we really want to sanction high school baseball, at least start the study of it. So I wonder if there's enough momentum there statewide.
Well, I'm glad they're going to do it, because it'll put to rest all the questions that you and I have had over the years, whether it's doable. And certainly in the spring, if there are enough schools who want to do it, I mean, they'll sanction it. Normally, you need 20. You need 20 schools to start a sanctioned sport in South Dakota. You can have less, but I think for the most part, they want about 20 to be able to get something sanctioned. So if there's 20 schools out there across the state that want to play high school baseball, maybe they can look at possibly sanctioning that.
Craig Maddock on tonight, SDPB Sports, East River meets West River. I want to ask you about a couple of Sioux Falls things that hit the wire there. What do you think of Tom Billiter, longtime Augustana coach, heading out the door?
I was shocked over it. And knowing Tom all these years, he could have been a lifer there at Augie. But it kind of sounds like the spark or the wick was starting to burn pretty near the end of the candle. And this opportunity has reinvigorated him, because he knows he's closer to the end of his coaching career than to the beginning. And I kind of think that maybe, whether you want to say he was getting bored or the challenge wasn't there or whatever it was, I think he wanted a different atmosphere, a different challenge. And that's why he picked up, because they called him out of the blue and asked him if he was interested. And I wish him all the best, because he's really good at what he does, but I was a little bit on the shock side.
Okay, because I was going to say, it's not like he was a step up or anything like that. It's kind of a lateral step there.
Well, Emporia State, they haven't had the most success recently, so it's kind of a rebuilding program. But Tom knows that he needs to build it up pretty quick. And you know, I think he will. He's got the name, and I think he'll do well at Emporia State. And, of course, his goal someday, hopefully next year, is at Emporia State and Augustana playing in some regional tournament game down the road.
Okay, I got to ask you about South Dakota State. They're coming out to Rapid City. I talked to Justin Sell, the AD. They put it together, South Dakota State men playing Northern Colorado at the Summit Arena at the Monument, November 14th. So I'm going to try and pump this thing up. I want to support it. We haven't had the Jacks out here since 1999, so it's a big thing. When it comes to South Dakota State basketball, I looked at the transfer portal. They lost their top two guys over 30 points per game. How do you handle that, Craig, when you're a South Dakota State program losing your top players now, it feels like, every year?
Yeah, this portal thing is getting way out of hand. I think the portal, one, shouldn't start until after the NCAA basketball tournament. And this is something that is on the minds of coaches all the time, because they never know, once their season is done, who's coming back. They really don't. And the good ones out there think, well, hey, there might be some money I can make if I transfer to this other school. And so it has really changed the landscape, I think, of college basketball. The Jacks, they're just going to have to realize that that's the way things are. You have a really good program. Most likely your players aren't going to stick around more than a couple of years, and you might not have a coach for very long if you're successful, because they'll move around too. The only thing I wished that the Jacks game out west would be like on a Friday or Saturday night.
Okay.
That would have been nice, but, you know, they're Jack fans out there, and they'll travel well, and you know, and then the Colorado fans, you know, it's not that far for them either. I think it'll be a great event.
I've heard there's no Northern Colorado fans, but no, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
Hey, remember, they used to be in the North Central Conference.
Yes,
remember that?
Yes, I do. That's what people have said. Not a huge crowd for Northern Colorado basketball, but we want a big crowd for the Jacks out here in Rapid City in November. Craig Maddock on tonight. His podcast is in play. Do you have a new one ready to go?
There will be one released next week, and I'll just tell you that it is a guy on a very short list of being a multi-sport athlete in South Dakota. Multi-sport athlete, and a lot of success. In fact, getting drafted in the NFL as well. And so that podcast coming up next week.
It is called In Play. You can download it where you find your podcast. Craig, always good, man. Thanks a lot.
See you around, Nate.
See ya. Craig Maddock tonight. East River meets West River. Sioux Falls versus Rapid City. Can I say that? Craig Maddock on tonight. SDPB Sports, longtime South Dakota sports broadcaster. We'll go to who's hot and who's not on a Wednesday night. Headlines you need to hear, like this NHL team on the move. An NHL team on the move? I've got that one for you. Plus, there's a new ticket that you could get for the Masters tomorrow. I'll tell you what it includes next.
Wasn't getting... The Horseshoe Restaurant at First Golden Deadwood makes dining out delicious and affordable. Every Wednesday from 11 till 8 p.m., enjoy traditional wings for $1 or boneless wings for 50 cents, served with your pick of 12 different sauces. Thursday, it's 2 for $20 burger night. Big and fresh burgers with your choice of side. The Horseshoe Restaurant proudly serves breakfast all day. And from 7 a.m. till 1 p.m., you can add one giant homemade pancake to your meal for only $2.99. The Horseshoe Restaurant at First Gold Gaming Resort in Deadwood.
Ever since Barron's Wilson Funeral Home first opened their doors in Rapid City 140 years ago, they have continued to make personal service their number one priority. In your time of grief, they offer a personal touch by being at your side through every step of the funeral process. They answer difficult questions and guide you toward other professional services you may need. See for yourself the wide variety of services they can provide for you by visiting their website at barronswilson.com.
Hi folks, Kevin McPherson, McPherson Auction Company. We can turn your property to cash. We can sell your personal property and your real estate at auction. A family business for 64 years and counting. We've sold several millions of dollars in property over the years. We're happy to consult with you on your auction plans. Let our selling experience work for you. Call McPherson Auction, 605-348-1369. Visit us on our web at McPhersonAuction.com.
Live from the Anytime Auto Sales Service and Details Studio, sales, service, and recreation, this is Fox Sports Rapid City.
All right, let's wrap up the Wednesday show. Glad to be back today. The Nate Brown Show live weekdays 4 to 6. Tomorrow we'll be back, and it's happy hour. Rob Kegron's coming live in studio tomorrow on the drive at 5. So Thursday show, always fun. And who's hot and who's not on a Wednesday night, brought to you by the Pizza Ranch, our favorite buffet. You know that. Best buffet in Rapid City is the Pizza Ranch. Fried chicken, cactus bread, salad bar, potatoes. I mean, it's good, good stuff. Two locations in Rapid City for your local Pizza Ranch. Rapid City Pizza Ranch South, Rapid City Pizza Ranch North, the Fun Zone Arcade. Take the kids, have some fun. Great Fun Zone Arcade at the Rapid City Pizza Ranch South. Who's hot and who's not here on the Nate Brown Show? Here we go. Some headlines you need to hear. In my who's hot category, I'm going to go with this new premium ticket for the Masters tomorrow. So Augusta National is debuting their new premium hospitality ticket where you get your tournament badge. So you get to go and you watch the tournament there. At Augusta National, they also get you all-inclusive food and drinks. All-inclusive food and drinks for the Masters and your tournament badge. What's it going to cost you? $17,000. $17,000. So you get all-inclusive food and drinks. You get to watch the Masters. $17K. Are you in? Well, sorry. They sold out. They're all sold out. So there's enough private jets coming in. They said there's going to be 1,500 private jets coming into Augusta this week. 1,500 private jets. In our Pizza Ranch Who's Not category, I want to go to this NHL team. It's a story that's just coming out this afternoon. The Arizona Coyotes look like they're working on a deal that would see the franchise sold to Ryan Smith. That's the Smith Entertainment Group. They own the Utah Jazz, Salt Lake City. So what does that mean? Well, it could mean the Arizona Coyotes could be going to Salt Lake City. That's interesting. I mean, you got the Utah Grizzlies out there in the ECHL. Does Salt Lake City want an NHL team? Are the Arizona Coyotes going to get that sale done to the owner of the Utah Jazz, and would that be then the Utah Coyotes? Keep an eye on it. Arizona Coyotes, it's been a tough deal down there. Tough deal. Not a lot of good fan support. They've had trouble. Kind of doesn't surprise me. The Coyotes have been in trouble on the NHL side. Thanks for listening to the Nate Brown Show. That's it for the Wednesday program. A lot of great guests from Arkansas Razorback live coverage. Brian Nowen tonight, Jerry Brewer, Craig Maddock, and Mike Middleton talking Masters. If you missed some of the show, go to the Nate Brown Show podcast, every show where you get your podcasts. We'll be back tomorrow at 4. The Odd Couple's on the way.
here's what you need to know.
Dallas police have an arrest warrant out for Chiefs wide receiver.